Okay students, I shall start off with the class, okay, because I have another class at 11:15 again. Okay. I hope you all can see my screen. Okay. So today we'll be speaking on the last unit, okay, that is representation and description. So I'll be taking up the first topic today, that is representation schemes, okay. So when we talk about an image representation, what do you understand by representation of an image? So in general terms, when we say representation of an image means what? Simply we are trying to represent an image using some specific techniques, right? So image representation and description, okay, or we can also say object representation and description. That is, it is critical for successful detection and recognition of objects in a scene. That is, when we talk about some scenes, then this image or object representation and description, it becomes a very critical part. Why? Because we want successful detection and recognition of the objects in that scene, right? So after you have taken the image and it has been segmented into, say, two parts. Remember, bimodal histogram. So when an image, when talking about image segmentation, and when talking about the techniques in it, so after the image has been segmented into two parts, that is the object and the background regions, so what happens is that it intends to represent and describe them in characteristic features for computer processing. You can say for computer processing, or you can say for other methods, and this happens during pattern recognition or in quantitative codes for efficient storage during image compression. Okay, so today we talk about image compression as well. That is, when you have taken the image and you have segmented into object and background regions, so those regions, these are intended to represent and describe in some characteristic features. Why? For processing of the computer parts, that is for some computer processing techniques, and which is used during some pattern recognition or in quantitative codes. Okay, and that is again efficient for image compression. Okay, so previously we took about coding, that is run length encoding, then binary tree, then quad tree representations. So these all will be again included here today. Okay, I hope you remember what is run length encoding and then how to represent a quad tree. I hope you remember. Okay, then so starting with object representation and description, so do you remember this part, that is image analysis and fundamental steps? This is the first utmost topic which we took up for the first lecture. These are the fundamental steps in image processing. So do you remember these steps? Image analysis. So how many steps we have? Actually we have 10 steps, not 10, actually we have 11 steps. Okay, here they are, they are representing 6 steps. So starting with image acquisition. So what is image acquisition? So image acquisition is, this is the first step, right? This is the first step, or this is the utmost important step in digital image processing, right? That is, you are taking an image which is already in a digital form. So image acquisition means what? To perform all the other techniques beyond, you have to acquire the image, right? So image acquisition, this stage, it involves pre-processing. And pre-processing means what? We have three methods for that. One is scaling, one is rotation, and one is translation. Actually we have other methods also, say reflection and all, but we talk about mainly scaling, translation and rotation. Yes, so image acquisition, the step involves pre-processing, which includes scaling, rotation, and translation. What is scaling? Do you remember what is scaling? Scaling means what? To change the size of an object, whatever you are taking. Yes. Then rotation means what? Rotation means you are trying to rotate the object at some particular angle from its origin, right? And translation. Translation is nothing but you are moving an object from one position to the other on the screen, right? So very simple steps: scaling, rotation, and translation. And these are all included in image acquisition. Then comes pre-processing enhancement. So what is pre-processing enhancement? Or normally they are talking about image enhancement here. So image enhancement means what? It is the most simple technique or area, you can say, in image processing, right? That is, you are using enhancement techniques in order to bring out the particular minute details or features of the image, whichever you are using it. How? By simply highlighting some certain features of interest in an image. That is, for all images also, you can't extract all the properties, right? Because every image, whatever you take, every image is different from the other image, and every image will have some particular features, right? So this enhancement technique is what? It is used so that it can bring out the particular minute detail which is hidden, or say it is hidden because of some foreign particles present, say noise. That is, in standard digital image processing language, we say it as noise. So in order to bring out the detail that is hidden or hidden because of noise, or simply to highlight some certain features of interest in that particular image, okay, that is what, say for example, intensity contrast or changing the brightness, yes, or say contrast stretching. So these all are types in processing or pre-processing image enhancement. Then comes segmentation. So segmentation, you already know what is segmentation. That is, you are partitioning or you are segmenting an image into parts or objects in order to bring out the features of the objects, and finally you club that part, right? So image segmentation is also a very interesting area in digital image processing, but it is also one of the very difficult tasks, as you have already gone through this part. Yes, so in some part it is very it is very easy. Overall it is an interesting part, but it's easy. Sometimes it's also difficult in carrying out the segmentation in different parts. Then we have representation and description, which we will be talking, or we are already talking about today. So representation and description, so this is followed by these steps. That is, first image acquisition has to be done, then pre-processing and enhancement, then segmentation. After that only it is followed by representation. That is, representation and description, this is almost, you can say, almost always it follows the output of a segmentation stage. And that is, usually you are taking some pixel or raw pixel data, okay, and that constitutes either boundary of a region or all the points in that region itself, okay. So representation and description, that is, it is talking mostly about the regions and the boundaries of an image. That is, region or boundary description of a particular image. So when you choose a representation, that is, choosing a representation, when you are choosing a representation, it is the only part of the solution for transferring the raw data, that is, the raw pixel data, into some suitable form. Why? For subsequent computer processing. Okay. And description here means it deals with some extraction of attributes, that is, extracting features from the image that results in some quantitative information of interest, or some basics for differentiating one class of object from the other. Because we are talking about object representation and description as well, so description, it deals with extracting features or attributes which will result in some quantitative information. Okay, quantity, it wants some quantity information of interest, or some basics for differentiating one class of objects from the other. Okay, and finally classification, interpretation and recognition, we'll go through this in the next part. Okay, then representation and description. So now you know what is representation and description. So it is, this part is this stage is followed by output of a segmentation stage, and this is commonly, so this is commonly after segmentation, and one needs to represent objects in order to describe them. That is representation. For representation and description, you definitely need objects to represent them and to describe them. And representation and description, it talks about mostly the regional and the boundary description of the image. So we have two parts here. One is external, that is the boundary, and the internal, which is the regional. So external or boundary of an object, it consists again of two parts, that is representation, say for example polygon of the boundary, that is actually boundary of the polygon. So suppose you're talking about some shape, you are trying to analyze the boundary. So that is representation. And then description means the circumference of the polygon. Then internal. So these are just examples. Okay, just remember representation and description. It talks about representing the regional and the description, regional and the region and the boundary. Okay, representation, description of objects, it describes the region and boundary of objects, and this step is followed by output of segmentation stage, and after that one needs to represent the objects in order to describe them. And we have two techniques, or we have two parts, we have two types of representation and description here. One is the external or boundary, and one is the internal or regional. External boundary talks about the representation and description of the object, and internal regional also talks about the representation and description. But external means the boundary, internal means the regional, that is the pixels. So pixels inside the object, or say the average color of the object. Okay, so we have two types, one is external or boundary and one is internal or regional. Okay, then it is talking about how it is representing. So representation of the object is means encoding of the object. So encoding, we again, you know, we have Huffman encoding, then run length encoding. So these all will again be used here. Okay, truthful but possibly approximate. So if you even use these techniques, it's okay, fine, you'll get the correct results, but possibly approximate, that is almost accurate results you'll be getting. Then a descriptor of the object. A descriptor of the object means only an aspect of the object, that is description, only some aspect or part of the object will be described, and this descriptor is suitable for classification of the object. Classification, it is classifying into parts according to the features of the object. So say for example, consider invariance to, say for example, noise translation. So it's talking about these parts, it's talking about these noise and translation. So descriptor of object, it describes some part or aspect of the object which is suitable for classification of the object as well. Then we have shape representation. So see, these are all talking about the regions, then shapes, then boundaries, then edges of the particular object. So now we talk about shape representation. So shape representation here, sometimes necessary or desirable to represent an object in a less complicated or more intuitive way. That is, shape representation is sometimes used which when it is necessarily or desirably allowing to represent an object in a less complicated or more intuitive way. That is, shape representation is not always used, only when it is necessary and desirable to particularly represent an object. Simple descriptions like encoding circle, enclosing circle, enclosing rectangle, inscribed circle, etc. So to describe simple descriptions of this circle, rectangle and circle, again, so shape representation is used. Then the boundary or the boundary segments. So it talks about the boundary and the boundary segments as well. Then dividing objects into regions or parts, and representation by skeleton. So this method will, this is not needed actually. So till here, So you can use shape representation for dividing an object into regions or parts. Then you can also describe the boundary or boundary segments of the object. Then you can simply describe descriptions of circle and rectangle, and also you can use it for representing an object sometimes when it is necessary or desirable in a less complicated or more intuitive way, that is shape representation. So we have examples for all these types, so I'll show you with an example like in the next slides. Okay, so here they are talking about scale, rotation and translation again. So scale, rotation and translation, so you already know, so scaling, rotation, translation, right? So scaling means to reduce, that is to change the size of an object. Rotation means to rotate the object by a particular angle from its origin, and translation means to move or shift the position of the object from one place to another, right? So here what happens in optical character recognition, example they are giving, rotation and scale is very important. Say for example, when you are describing these, when taking into account these techniques and you are describing optical character recognition, rotation and scale is very important. Say for example P, when you rotate this, what happens? It becomes D, right? So rotation and scaling is very important, particularly in optical character recognition. So this is also another chapter, so this is not required, just this is an example for scaling, rotation and translation. Okay, and then we have chain code. Okay, so chain code is a part of a contour based shape descriptor. So we spoke about shape description, right? So shape representation, it is also represented by a particular type, that is a chain code, which is a contour based shape descriptors. So what happens in chain code? It describes the sequence of steps generated when walking around the boundary of an object, and chain code can be defined for 4 and 8 neighbors. So this chain code is very interesting, I'll show you now. So how it is shown is, say these are the directions. Okay, these are the north, south, east and west directions, and these are positioned by, or these are numbered by 1, 0, 3 and 2. So towards moving upwards is 1, moving to the right is north, south, east and west, right? No, north, south, east and west. So moving north is 1, moving south is 3, moving east is 0, moving west is 2, right? So taking this into account, again this is 8 descriptors. I show you the 4, how to use chain code for 4 neighbors. So moving north is 1, moving south is 3, moving east is 0, moving west is 2. So let's see an example here. Okay, suppose you are given a chain code example of this string, this pattern of digits. Say the 0000303032, 11 quadruple 2 3 2 1 3 2 11 0 11, right? So you have to describe this using a chain code and using this particular pattern. Okay, so what is it? So suppose how you represent it in this image, right? So four way connected. So this is for four way, this is for representing four neighbors of the image. Say 000, so you know now, so moving towards the east is 0, right? So 000 is 000. Can you see this 000? Then 30, so again 3 is to the south, so 3 then 0, again 3 then 0, again 3 then 0, then comes 3232. So 3 and 2 is towards the west, so 32, again 32. Now 1 is towards the north, so double ones we have, so 11. Then we have quadruples 2, that is towards the west, so 2 2 2 2, right? Again 3 is towards the south, so 3, again 2 double 1, so this is 2, this is double 1. Then again 0 and triple 1, so 0 1 1 1. So this is the output of the image after you have taken into account chain code using this pattern. And this is for 4 connected neighbors. Okay, did you get it? Same way for 8 connected. So for 8 connected, they are using this pattern. So it's also given over here. So say a pattern of number or digits is given 0000776542 3445422 12. Same thing, use it in this way. So 000 here, this 000. So can you see here? So 000 means it is towards the east. So 000, right? So 000. Again 777. So 777 is diagonally south. Not diagonally south. This is north, south, east. So southeast you can say. Okay, so this is 777. So 7, 7, and 7, right? So 654. So this is 6 towards the south. This is southwest, and 4 is to the west. So 6, 5, and 4. Yes, so 2, 3, 4. So 2, 3, 4. So 2, 3, 4. 4. So taking into account this pattern, you have to draw the pattern first. You have to give the directions first, and then whatever example you'll be getting, you have to use this pattern, and then you have to draw the chain code. Okay, so chain code for 8 connected neighbor is this. So did you understand this 4 code and 8 code? I mean 4 connected and 8 connected using a chain code for 4 neighbors and 8 neighbors. Yes, so it's easy, right? So expect this question in the exam. Okay, this is very easy. So anyhow, the question will be almost like I have to check it first. That is, it has to lastly connect it to the origin point, that is to the origin. Okay, so the code has to be in such a way that it is connecting finally to the origin. Okay, so this is about chain code. So this is the first topic, that is how you represent. This is representation schemes for representation and description of an object. Okay, so I hope you understood these topics for today. That is, you have to remember the fundamental steps first. These are the fundamental steps in image processing, that is when talking about object representation or image representation and description. Okay, then they talk about representation and description, why it is needed, when it is needed, and how many types are there. That is, we have two types. One is external or boundary, and one is internal or regional. Then we have representation descriptions, how it is represented, that is using encoding of the object. And then representation of object is represented using encoding of the in terms of encoding of the object. And descriptor of the object means only some part or aspect of the object is being defined, and this descriptor is very suitable for classification of the object. Then shape representation, it talks about the object. It talks about a particular object. That is, shape representation is only used when the object has to be represented in a more or in a less complicated or intuitive way. It is also used to represent circle, rectangle, and boundary or boundary segments of an object. Then division of object into regions or parts using shape representation. Then talks about scaling, rotation, and translation, which we already know these terms. And mainly they are giving an example of optical character recognition, where rotation and scale is very, it plays a very important part in it. And then it's talking about the chain code, which is a contour based shape descriptor, which is used, or chain code, it is described by sequencing the number of steps generated when walking around the boundary, and it is represented in a 4-way connected and 8-way connected in four connected or eight connected way, where it is defining four and eight neighbors of the region respectively. Okay, and these are the patterns for four neighbor, eight neighbor respectively, and taking into account you'll be given some examples, and accordingly you have to fit these patterns in this image to get the output, that is the chain code. Okay, so we have only few topics left, so we'll go very slowly, okay, or else we'll finish off with the syllabus very soon and then we'll have nothing left to do. Okay, so let's stop it here for today. Okay, so did you understand these topics for today? Did you get the topics today? Okay, so let's stop it here for today. So you can proceed to the next class, and if you have any doubt, you can ping me in the group. Okay. Thank you.